brought to you in living color. Well, almost. Hi everybody, and welcome back to Plastic Models by Regular Dude, and part number 3 of the Hasegawa 1/72 scale KI-51 Sonya. In the last episode, I got all of the construction done on the whole thing, with the exception of a few small parts, such as the bombs, the tail wheel, the propeller, antenna, pitot tube, rear-facing machine gun, and the machine gun barrels. All of that I'm going to paint separately and assemble them at the end. So I'm ready to actually start applying some paint. For the primer, I used SMS Surfacer Gray Acrylic Lacquer Primer. Really good stuff. The reason I use gray instead of black is I used the black to see if there was any spots on the aircraft I needed to fill in, seam lines, stuff like that. I do have a little bit of a divot here, but I think the machine gun barrel will kind of cover that up. I'm not gonna worry about it at this point. But everywhere else, my seam line repair worked out really well. So a little tiny bit of a piece there, but once I get color on it, may not notice, but whatever. So the first plan of action is to spray some white. And that is going to be sprayed on the tail and right here where this, I don't know how to pronounce it, Hinomaru or something like that, there, and then on the upper wing surfaces as well. And then on the leading edge of the wing, I believe, where this yellow will be sprayed. The reason I'm going to do that is I want to get all that a good base white, and then I will hand cut some stencil or some masks to put in place for all of those parts, the band, the whole shoot and match. So what I need to do first is I need to spray some white. As a matter of fact, a good portion of this is going to be sprayed white, because I want to make sure that I don't miss any spots. So, like I said, for that I'm going to use SMS Premium White. So I am going to load up the old airbrush and do that, and then I'll come back and we'll look at what I'm going to do for masks. So let's cut the masks for this thing. So the first thing I need to do, I have my decals here. I have a piece of paper off screen here, since I'm zoomed in, and I need to take a few measurements. So the first measurement I need to take is the outside diameter of the first Hinomaru, which is the upper wing measurement. Now that comes out right about, it's hard to see the white part, it comes out right about 16 millimeters. So we got 16 millimeters for the outside. Then for the inside, I've got 14 millimeters. Okay, 14 millimeters. So that's my measurements for the Hinomarus, and then the 14 millimeter will be the same for the lower wing as well. So that'll take care of all of those. Then for the fuselage, it is 11 millimeters. So I'll write that down, 11 millimeters. Then the inside circle, 10 millimeters. All right, so that takes care of the measurements. The next thing I need is some material. And for that, I'm going to use this Tamiya full sheet, already obviously been used, masking material. for the actual masks themselves. Apparently it's the same stuff as their rolled tape, just in a sheet form so you can make bigger stuff and that type of thing. To actually make the cuts, I am going to be using this handy Shadow Hobby Thinner Line Circle Cutter and Shadow Hobby Circle Cutter Locator. So here's how this thing works. So you have this central portion here that has the knob that you use for cutting and for making adjustments. You just loosen it and you can slide it back and forth to make adjustments. There's this hard outer ring here, which obviously has needle bearings or something inside. There's a kind of a rubbery grippy material on the bottom to keep it from sliding around. And then there's the actual cutter here, and it's spring loaded. So you have it protrude just ever so slightly below the surface of this, so it will cut the material underneath. On here are some measurement gradations, and there are millimeters, and there's a little marker arrow right there. So that's how you know what size to cut everything. So let's set the cut size first. So we've got 16 millimeters for the outside. So we'll loosen this, and you may not be able to see exactly what I'm doing here, but so we got 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Right there. Okay, so then here's the important part, and when you set this thing down on something, you don't want to set the cutter right on your desktop surface, because you don't want to damage it. So I'll put it right there. So here's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna get this, see where it's gonna cut, and get it as close to this edge as possible to eliminate too much waste. Now this isn't sitting all the way on here, so I can do this. Okay. Then we take this part here and we set it right up against the edges of this outer ring. Hold that in place, hold the ring, and make the first cut. Make a few passes like that. Okay. Then, without letting this move, you move this away so you can make your next cut, which is 14 millimeters. So, right there. Okay, make sure that doesn't move. What this does is it ensures that you have a concentric circle. And you swing it around like that. Okay? So that's what we've got. So I need to do that again for another circle. And then once I set for the center circle, after, you know, on this second mask, then I can go ahead and cut the other two, which don't have the white ring around it. And then you just do the same thing for the smaller. So that's really all there is to it. So let me get those cut out and we'll come back and actually stick them on the aircraft. Now the trick is to get this to come off together like this. See, that's worked out pretty well because it didn't cut all the way through. It's exactly what I wanted. So then I can just take it using my illustration to make sure I get it where it's supposed to be, mostly. Looks like good right there. That's where I'm gonna go. Let's put that there. I'm gonna use a Q-tip to burnish it in place. Especially the outside. There we go. So I'll put the rest on and then come back again. And with those cut and installed, hopefully I can get the center ring or the center circle out. I'm just going to try and lift it carefully where the cut is. Carefully. Oh, almost forgot. Right wing, left wing, left. The reason I'm doing this is because if there is variance, because this is not exact, if there's variance, then I'll be sure to get the circle in the right one. So we got that peeled off. We'll just stick it on there like that. There we go. On there, all nice. So now I'm ready to do the red. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray red all over that there, red all over that there. Then I'm gonna just spray red in that general area, red and red. Then I'll come back in, put the mask circles back in each corresponding place, and then just put a mask circle there and there, and I'm ready to paint the upper and lower colors. All right, here's what it looks like with the red sprayed on it. So the next thing I need to do, and what I use to paint it, is Tamiya XF7 flat red. Anymore, I don't really prefer to use Tamiya paints, just for one reason, and this is going to sound weird coming from a military modeler, is it is too flat. But no big deal, it's what I had on hand, and I can put a gloss coat over it whenever I'm all done, because I'm going to have to use Tamiya for the upper and lower surface colors as well. But first, I need to put these circles back in place. So here comes the fun part. Now hopefully I won't get my noggin in the way, but I'm using my Optivisor to make sure I get this lined up properly. So I may have to do this off camera, just so I can get into where I can see what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm gonna do this off camera, so I'll be back. Okay, it looks pretty close, but just to play it safe, I'm going to very carefully write along this edge, because I don't think it's centered, because you can see where it's kind of lifted right there. So I'm going to use this and very carefully apply some all along that where this meets the outside ring, and that should take care of any unwanted colors from getting in there. Okay, I got my masks cut for the lightning bolts on the tail, and all I did to do that was I used the decals. At first I was just going to cut them over top and peel it off, but as you can see, it peeled off some of the decals well, so that didn't work. So what I did is I just cut one completely out and used that as a template. I laid it on some Tamiya tape, cut them, they're ready to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray the leading edges of the wings and the tail section yellow using MRP RLM04, which is a little, it's not a real bright yellow, and it looks pretty close to what I can see in the photos and, you know, colors other people have used. So I'm gonna get spraying on that. Once it dries, then I can stick those masks on there and then get on with the main colors. Okay, here's a quick little look at what's going on here. So I sprayed the gray on the bottom, and for that I used, let me see which one I used. Oh, here it is. I used XF12 JN Gray. I'm not sure if that's right, but that's the color I used. So got that sprayed on. Then I got everything, masked, so I don't get any overspray on anything I don't want overspray on. And now I can spray the green. But as you can see, there's some silver on here. So what I did is I sprayed SMS Metallic Super Silver, and then sprayed on some hairspray so I can do a little bit of chipping here and there. And now I'm ready to spray it with XF70, which is I think it's just called dark green. So I'm ready to do that, and then I can let that dry, start doing some chipping and stuff like that. But first I need to spray the green, so I'm gonna make sure all my tape is looking good here. And then I'm going to spray the green. And now for the moment of truth. And there it is. Not perfect, but this is either the second or third time I've done masking. I am pretty stoked with the Hino Marus. Those actually turned out pretty good. I got a little bit of white paint bleed there, but these sides, I'm really stoked with that because of how fine that edge turned out. My lightning bolts, they're fine. Front edge, you got a little bit of green there, so I'm gonna have to tape along that and maybe respray that. But yeah, I am really stoked with the way that turned out. So now I'm gonna let it sit for a little bit, make sure it dries really well, and then I'll do some chipping where the hairspray was. I also sprayed the prop, and for that I used XF64, which is red brown, but looks pretty good. I think that'll work fine. And so I'm getting close here, folks, close. So the next thing I want to do is I need to paint these tires and repaint this. I also need to glue in the machine guns into the wings, which are these two things here, so I can paint those black. And then I can start thinking about peeling this stuff off. I need to determine if I want to put a clear coat on here or not. Not sure I'm gonna, but we'll see. So I'll work on these machine guns, and to paint the tires, excuse me, I'm gonna use AK third generation acrylic modeling colors, rubber black. As you can see, I've got some stuff smeared all over this, and what I've used is, well, real quick, like I got the rubber painted, I got the exhaust painted, and I got all the small parts painted and ready to go for installation. So what I did is I wanted to do a wash, and I didn't want to do a really stark black wash. So I used this Ultimate Weathering Wash Light Dirt. We'll see how that looks. But I basically just applied it on there. And let it dry. And then just rub it off with a Q-tip. So a number of things is going on here. It's reducing the starkness of the color, adding a little bit of streaking. It's also toning down these markings so they're not quite so garishly red. Now this stuff, I gotta say that I really like this stuff, and I know of other people who do too. They work really well, and they're easy to use, easy to remove, gives you some good, you know, like in this case. And what I do is I like to rub it off in the direction of airflow, so that way any streaking that's left, it's going to be with the airflow, so it's, you know, looks a little more true to form, so to speak. So I'm going to keep working on that, then I'll flip it over and do the same thing on the other side. All right, well, I had shot some closing remarks on this before I go on to my final video for slideshow and stuff, but it didn't work. So basically here it is. The kit is done, and I am going to call this video quits right here. And next time we come back for part 4, I'll give my thoughts on the kit, talk a little bit about what I used on the kit, and then do a slideshow. So that's it for now for part 3 of the Hasegawa 1/72 scale KI-51 Sonya. So if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more of my videos, hit the subscribe button. And maybe hit the notification deal so that way you'll know when they pop up, if you're interested. So if you have any questions, comments, hits, tips, concerns, put them in the comments section down below, and I'll get back to you. Or if you just want to chat, I'm good with it. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching Plastic Models by a Regular Dude. Until next time, I will see you all later.